Recently, you all have gotten to witness, two occasions that are very rare. One of which was my video about true leaving, where I admitted I was wrong. And tonight, I'm actually going to be quiet for a change, because I just got through watching Solar's account of what happened with the baby, and it's pretty much what I thought, but still, nevertheless, heartbreaking. And I know all I'll do is boohoo cry, like I got the snotty nose and everything tonight, guys. So I'm not going to say much. So, like I said, two very rare occasions, me admitting I'm wrong and me being quiet. But nevertheless, I do want to share this story with you guys. I know that it's close to your heart too. And I just want to put it out there as soon as possible. It is the T's content. So shouts out to the T for always, bringing it. And we'll go from there. Please do like and comment and subscribe, because I'm still going to make the sequel about the death of Solar and Zoka's baby. I just haven't quite gotten around to it, because it's just such a difficult subject for me, having lost my own 7-week-old son, Gavin. So it does take a toll. So with that said, I'm going to go ahead and give you the story.
Pray God you can call. This woman's work, oh, it's hard on the man. Now his part is over. Now starts the craft of the father. I know you've got a little life in you left. I know you've got a lot of strength.
We made about 25 bands off of Bigo before. That was on me, because I was flipping the PKs and I figured out how to use the lucky bags. I figured out the algorithm for the lucky bags, and I was able to hit millions on people. And I was able to do cool stuff off of that. So we hit big one time in Puerto Rico off of that. But they're desperate. Money's running low. They gotta go. It's time to grow. Eligio. Let go, for real. I mean, focus on, go to jail, bro. Go to jail. The reason why I'm telling you to go to jail is because it's for your best interest to acknowledge what you've done. He said, what'd he say? He said,
his neck. His right now.
Huh?
He better live in his right now.
For real. Well, but that's the thing. How you teach a knowledge that you're not applying. So you mean to tell me you teach divine knowledge yourself at a high scale to where I should honor you, but you haven't acknowledged that your people are at a low vibration, servant attitude, servant frequency, and that you're going to live in that same frequency? You mean to tell me you didn't know that? You didn't mean to tell me that you didn't know that you had to uplift your people for everything to grow, including yourself, or they would have to go? The only reason why you have to isolate is because you're greedy, bro. It's because you're out of your purpose. You're in your lower self. You're in your lower natures. Eligio, you're greedy. This is why. You're greedy. That's what it boils down to. You have to be by yourself. And that's okay. That's your nature. Some people are like that. I'm not like that. People like me, if I'm around you, y'all got to be just as dope. You see what I'm saying? I'm not like him. We all got to level up, or somebody going to have to vibrate out. It's just like that. That's why I have this private group of people who choose to be successful. I do their charts, sure enough, money, money, money. In everybody's charts, it's like, yo, Taurus, Jupiter, Taurus. You know, second house, Midhaven, Taurus, Midhaven, Jupiter, Leo, North Node, fifth house, Leo, North Node, Sagittarius. All this beautiful stuff, just beautiful placements. Just Jupiter and Taurus and Leo everywhere. Just money, money, money. Capricorn everywhere. Virgos all over the place. That's money all over the place. I just did a chart with two grand earth trines in the best places, all home placements. These people's charts are crazy. So I know the universe ain't playing with me. We win it. Whatever I'm doing over here, we win it. That's all I know. Whatever he got going on is depleting and is doing this for a reason. They're living against nature. He's trying to make his own rules in a world where there's, guess what, laws, rules. There's some laws you can't break, bro. And you're going to have to answer for all that shit you did in the past. And Shaka, I apologize if we ever looked at you or talked about you in a crazy way. Because I remember when y'all left, y'all was exposing what had happened on that hill that night. And that was major. That right there, I don't even know how Carbonation made it a day past that. I don't even know how we made it a day past that. That was blatantly public battery of a woman. Like, yo, and that's the same night he had made Zoka drink mad alcohol. That was at Capricorn full moon. I'll never forget that night. I remember that.
Wow.
And that's crazy. So, like, I feel so bad that we made Velvet look crazy. I feel bad we made Natiri look crazy. And I had the definitions here. I was going to pull it up. I'm just going to pull up some articles, and I'm going to read a definition that I had read before.
You know, we already talked, bro. We good.
Yeah, I mean, there's a specific one I had found. It was very interesting. I can do it off of memory, and I can find the reference later because I'm not going to go do the whole camera lesson thing right now. But I'll just say it off of memory is that the form of rape that was mostly of a reach is my favorite one, and this is the fraudulent one. This is the one where you pretend to be something that you're not in order to get some pussy or in order to get something. Like, for example, acting like a government official and telling them, hey, if you don't do this, you can go to jail. So give me a little something and I'll let you go. That's rape. There's one common denominator every time. So I don't know how this same common denominator has the audacity to get online saying they left because they couldn't handle it. And they traded on you. They traded on you. So Shaka traded on you when you violated this man with his wife by disrespecting his wife. When you violated this man by disrespecting his wife, he traded on you. When you violated me by disrespecting my wives and lying to me publicly and everybody, we traded on you. If those women were to leave, because they don't like being with a man who beats them for no reason and pees on them for his pleasure. Is that trading on you? If that's the case, I mean, it's you against the world, and it should be you against the world. And I wish you the best of luck, because nobody should be with anybody who does that to them. Period. Pyramid. Right? If they knew what that meant. If only they knew what they did. I noticed that they repeat, 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 repeat. They're programmed. They repeat. They don't understand knowledge. They repeat knowledge. They don't know anything about
right now. Share the motherfucking. My
it's
nigga
disrespect. Well, yeah. I mean, I think about this stuff all day. I just don't go on live, and then right. I tolerate the stuff, and then I listen to certain things, and I'm like, I just talk to him, and then I see what he goes on live saying. Bro, you wrong, bro. Because you come to the people completely wrong.
I mean, the same way.
It's completely wrong. And I'm like, I'm usually not caring. You know, I did come in here. I let you guys know what I was doing, what my business is, what I'm on. When it comes to him, there's no trading. There's no talking shit. There's only telling the truth. The question is, how much truth are we going to tell? That's the question. That's the ultimate question is how much truth are we going to tell? Nobody talking shit. I'm just wondering how much truth do we tell? What do I have to not reveal? What are you willing to expose for yourself? You know, at the end of the day. And I don't blame anybody there. Anybody there who's ever done anything, the women, all the slapping, all the smacking on all of those people. I don't blame nobody. I absolve everybody of their sins because, look, they were under your influence, bro. They wouldn't have never, they wouldn't have done that stuff otherwise. They don't build like that. They're not like, what's, oh, I missed the count. I missed the crime count. What was the one I missed? False imprisonment.
That's five charges.
Do you know how hard it is to leave carbonation? Do you know how hard it is? Why you think niggas sneak out? They ain't got the time. I'm not trying to give you a whole dark harvest before I leave. You trying to feed on my the last soul that I can get and let me just walk out with the least? No, I'm good. At the end of the day, niggas leave and sneak out not because they scared or any reason other than they don't got time for you. They know what you on. They want to leave. They don't want to get smacked. They don't want to get hit. They don't want to get held back. They don't want the drama. They want to take what they want to take and they want to go. You see what I'm saying? That's why people leave. That's why they run out, because they know what time it is. In order to leave carbonation, you got to get what? You actually, to leave, she wanted to leave. We're in the meeting. The meeting's going hours. Still wants to leave. I want to go. This person should be able to get up and walk out those doors. But if she got up and just walked out those doors and that was disrespect to him, she's at risk of getting beat up. She's at risk of getting jumped. That is not a situation you go and have sex with people right afterwards.
Right.
That's coercion. Notice how they pinned coercion on their page. They put it right. They put their name tag on. That's what they did. That's what it was. That's where they fucked up. This is where the rape is wrong. It's rape by coercion, because if there is any type of physical violence at all leading up to the act, it doesn't matter if she said yes, no, maybe, kind of. It's out of fear for her own safety immediately. This is the one that I would use if I was a lawyer. That's easy. Is it true that this and that same night she said she loved this other man and you had her instructed to be beaten by his ex, by his current wife that you're currently sleeping with? Yeah, okay. And what did she do? She smacked her repeatedly times. Under whose command? Eligio's. Why? Because she made a face that he didn't like. Okay, what happens after that? She wants to leave. She tells the world she loves me again and says that she wants to leave. Okay, she gets her bag. She's able to get the Uber. She's about to leave. I know we didn't pay for the Uber. So I know we didn't pay for it, so she did something. She got an Uber. She's about to leave. Hey, he said he wanted to say something to you. All right, damn. I'm a Capricorn in the first house with a Gemini moon. I got too much pride. I'm going to go upstairs and talk and tell them, hey, I'm leaving. Goodbye. I love you guys. The same shit that I do. Just how I left their room, knowing that they were going to block me, saying, peace, y'all, love y'all. Knowing that I was going to get blocked, but just saying, hey, peace, on some love. I'm not leaving on no weirdo shit. I'm leaving cool. And I actually left carbonation. That's how I left carbonation. I left carbonation very cool. I left so cool that two people left with me. I wasn't even like that. It wasn't on that type of time. That's just what happened. Lucien Price is like, yeah, that makes too much sense. We want to leave. We want self-respect. We have self-respect. We don't like how you treat us, period. That's what it boils down to. We're men. We want to go build something on our own. We want to go be in our purpose. This isn't trading on you, bro. This isn't turning on you. This is waking up. This is called maturity. This is called leaving the nest. Okay? We were disciples, and we agreed to certain disciplines. We agreed to certain things, to learn certain things. You didn't teach me anything ROTC didn't teach me. You didn't teach me anything Bobby Hemmett didn't teach me. You didn't teach me anything Malachi wasn't teaching us. There's nothing special about the knowledge. I found something special in the knowledge through this 369 information, which I have proof, Mente can prove it, and other people can prove it. I've been teaching this way before carbonation. Because this is me. So no, I'm not trying to be a Legio. I'm me. This is how I am. That's why my family never tripped, because they're like, oh, he's just being himself. They thought I was going to go to Tibet and be a monk. But that's what they thought I was going to do, but I wanted to keep my hair. You know, so I ended up being carbonation over time. But that what you see what I'm saying? I was in my south node. I was supposed to never go there. I was supposed to never be that, but I didn't know myself. I have a Taurus 11th house south node. Leo is a Taurus in the 11th house. Number one, I'm not supposed to be in a collective or a group or a cult. Number two, Taurus 11th house. Nigga, that's him. Stay away from him. And I spent 4 years with that nigga. 4 years out of place. Yeah, no, Tauruses, I love Tauruses, but y'all been tripping, bro. I had to cut off another Taurus recently, too. Y'all Taurus is cool, man, but y'all be bugging, bro. Like, that controlling thing ain't cool for a sovereign soul.
It's stubborn, that motherfucker. Stubborn, nigga.
Yeah, I mean, I love y'all Tauruses, man, but y'all got to let people be, man. Y'all got to let people be themselves. And you got to learn how to be successful on your own and deal with people in your frequency, man. Deal with people in your lane. Deal with people up your echelon and, you know, build. I love Tauruses. I ain't going to cap. I love Tauruses. It's just, y'all got a bad taste in my mouth right now. That's it. And then the tarot readings lately, they've been saying these Tauruses is tripping. Like, watch out for these Tauruses are hating on you. You know, and I'll say this as well. I could be wrong about this one, but I believe that when I got off the phone with the Leo after all the love and all the love he was sharing with me and all the love I was giving him back and respect I was giving him back, right? I just know that when that phone hung up, it was, man, fuck that nigga. I already know it. I don't know if you know what I mean when I say, like, you can just feel something. The moment I hung up the phone, I'm just like, that was so fake. Like, he didn't mean none of that. After he hangs up that phone, I know he's like, fuck that nigga. I just know it.
Right.
There's too much fakeness now. That's the first thing I expect from him now was some fake shit. And now I've realized that he's very far from real. I was raised real, and I've seen some phony ways. That was him. You know, right. I've seen some ways from him, and I've learned how not to be from him, and I realized that he's hiding. And my thing is, how many secrets do I expose? How many secrets do I leave for him to expose for himself? All I know is that if he comes for me, or he comes for Lotus, or he come for anybody who's left. Because that's all family. That's all still family. It's like, you still got lightning bolts, bro. I got more lightning bolts in the factory. Like, we got a factory.
King, let me say something. He's a Taurus male. You know, like, yep. I know he is not going to expose himself ever. He was taught to manipulate from the age of 13, 14 years old. If you want to purge it all and let it go. Not for him, for you. This healing has nothing to do with him. This is all for you.
You know what? And that's what I've been saying. I actually say that forgiveness is an antidote that you have to take for yourself. I say that often to people. Forgiveness is an antidote you have to take for yourself. And one of the questions I was hoping to answer was, you know, why was I so loving and why was I so peaceful and why was I defending him in his room the other day? And the reason why I was doing that was because I believe I don't care how negative he seems, okay? I don't care how negative or how bad of a person he seems or is being. If you go in there insulting him or if you go in there living in that negative vibe, because that's what you experience from him or that you feel about him, that's going to become your life and your reality. That is very real. And I was defending people, letting you know, like, hey, I'm not defending him, but don't fall into the trap. It's a negativity trap. Don't fall into the trap because that's going to make you broke. Don't fall into the fake stuff. Don't fall into the bad vibes. Don't start calling him names and vibrating that way because you're going to meet – the more names you call him, you're going to meet people like that in your life to know what that is. You see what I'm saying? You don't want that. So only put certain things, like if anything, I'd be like, okay, I feel bad for you. You know, if anything, like I feel bad for him. Like that's how it feels. I feel like he's a crazy kid. He's a crazy guy who had a bad upbringing or something like that. And I just feel bad for him that he don't see it. And it's sad because he's supposedly teaches this stuff, but he don't see it. He's done what he's done and he still don't see it. You see what I'm saying? I feel bad for him. It's like a blind person. It's like he's special ed. It's not, and I know that's mean. That could be mean, but that's how I feel. I feel like, yo, it's like I feel bad for you. I'm not mad at you. I'm passionate within myself, and no, I'm already not wanting to give it so much energy, but I do think about it so much that it is worth a discharge. it is worth, you know, putting it all out in one place, you know, in timely fashions. I don't do this often. So if I do it, here it is. You know what I'm saying? I don't talk often. If you see me, here it is. You see what I'm saying? There's so much that I want to say more from my experience, but I still can't. Out of what? The defense for him. Why? Because I want to give him an opportunity to be real. So I there are things that I can outlet with her. I can outlet with other people. We could talk about, make sense of outside of that. But I can't talk about that on here. I can't talk about that online. I can't call him and talk about it either because he's blind to it. And the women are dumb, deaf, and blind to it. They hang up. They'll block you. Go ahead and name one moment when Malia ran out and why. Go ahead and name one moment when he's beaten any of these women and to what extreme. Just go ahead and name one. Just let's have a conversation about any random one of these events. There's too many to pick from. To where there's a reasons for them to leave and be out of there than other than this him now being in jail. All the men, I don't know what they know or don't know. Juju, I feel worse for Juju. Juju didn't have a family. We were his only family. And by the time Juju got there, now he got to go back to Chicago and living in a very poor way. Juju mad. I understand Juju. I get him. He's mad. He was just learning this knowledge from us. He was just up close with us, learning so much. And now it's like, what? And he don't know Natiri. He don't know Elihio. So he's over here riding for him and not knowing what he riding for yet. That's like me a couple years ago. Juju now. You see what I'm saying? Just wait till they got the opportunity. Let Elihio be out. Let him be with those women. And let's see how long until somebody leaves. Let's see how long until something violent happens. Let's see how long. Let's just wait. It's not normal. He promotes the normalcy of having violence in your household. I have a productive, actual game plan how to completely eliminate all of that and bring the family together. I have it's a part of my curriculum, how to bring the family together. That's a part of the curriculum. It's a requirement for being successful. You got to be able to bring your household together. How you guys expect to be successful? Your household split apart. You better just not disassociate with them at all, or it's inevitably y'all going to move away from each other. But that's a critical component. I have to offer and share with the world. They're not sharing it. I get passionate about that because now, just like being a slave, it's like now I've broken out of the chains, out of the slave from this kingdom. I want to break the slaves out everywhere else. So what? Soul redemption, sovereignty in every dimension. See what I'm saying? That's what I'm on now. And that's just what it is. And you name it. I know I can help the community. I found a way to touch and help the community in every way. Every way. So if anybody wants to deal with me, y'all go ahead and contact me. When it comes to outletting with him, you're right. There is a lot of stuff charged up. You see what I'm saying? I don't talk about it. We keep it in just like we was trained to, right? Just like those women do, just like Malia's doing. Right. Oh, we would never leave. I know y'all ain't gonna leave me. Yeah. Yeah, we ain't gonna leave.
To that bag getting a little bit lower.
Tonight, you will find out tonight. Efru gone. You know what I mean? Tonight, right after Black that line.
Okay, Solar. I have a question. I do have a question. And there's been a lot of questions surrounding one particular incident. And if you don't feel comfortable talking about it, I definitely understand. But you have a lot of mothers that love you and support you and Janae both. And there was something that really got underneath a lot of different people's skin because they just don't understand. And that is the night that your child was born. Yeah, is there any way that you can go into a little bit more detail of the events that happened that night?
I will. You know what? Because I found my limits. My limits are his business. I can't tell you what's in those videos on my phone. I'm just going to keep them on my phone. They're in my iCloud. So
right.
Just for a rainy day, you know. Just for a rainy day. So I play good chess. So anyway, that is something I'd like to talk about. You got to let me smoke real quick on that one. I'm going to tell you exactly. I'm going to tell you what happened from the music. So she went into labor during the music video shoot. We were shooting a music video, song Love. Right. And she had went into labor then. And so I'm going to tell you from when she went into labor. We get to the hospital. They all leave. It's just me and her in the hospital. You know, they all get in a car and leave. You know, bad vibes. You know, and I give Elijio the shirt off my back. You know, I give him all kind of cool stuff. It's whatever. It is what it is, you know, and they leave all kind of crazy bad vibes. It is what it is, right? Always doing something for this nigga. Anyway, we get to the place. And I'll tell you what happened from there to when we got back to the house. So just give me a second. Just give me a second to breathe because my heart rate going up. And let me say this to you. Thank you for – I'm an honest person for real. If I'll tell you guys, like, yeah, you said, hey, you know, if you're holding on to this, let us know. This, that's real. We are. We're holding on to this stuff. That's a problem. We can't be holding on to this shit.
Yeah.
See, I turn it off because I want to get nothing kicked. You know, it's a problem. They're holding on to this stuff. You know, I don't know if y'all seen Pisces' page. This nigga going crazy, man. I love you, Pisces. If you hear me, man, I love you, man. You look like you going crazy, bro. Look like you reaching. I wish I could just invite everybody to my group, man. Just have everybody be in my group so I can be like, look, let's start over. Let me do your chart again. Let's start from ground zero. Let's figure you out again. Let's do this again, bro. There's certain things, and a lot of the knowledge was true. Don't abandon all the knowledge because he put a bad taste in your mouth. Like, bro, a lot of this stuff was true. It was just unfulfilled. We didn't apply most of the stuff we taught people. You see what I'm saying? Don't give it up. So, no, I mean, I just want to say those things, man. I really feel very passionately about everything. And I don't know if y'all know this or not, or y'all see it or not, but I'm a very successful person, and I'm doing very big things. And the truth is, you know, I've always been that person. It's just like a sleeping giant and waking up from a nightmare. You see what I'm saying? And a lot of us are like that. And a lot of us are in that nightmare right now, and you just don't know it because it's like the good place. It seems decent, but this might be you settling for a regular life when you could be a millionaire. If you're a U.S.-born citizen, you're set up to literally be a millionaire. If you don't know about sovereignty or getting know about that paperwork, let me know. That's what we do. That's one of the cornerstones of what we do. It's soul redemption, sovereignty in all dimensions. Do you understand? Yes, it's the occult knowledge, the real knowledge, without all the power attached, without all the you have to worship me attached. It's here. This is yours. Now use it. That's how it goes. So I'm about to tell y'all the story. I do want to tell y'all a little bit more about that because that is something I could tell. That's not his story. That's my story. And for Zoe as well. Ooh, that's a deep one. While I smoke this, let me ask y'all something. Y'all, anybody can answer this. What do y'all think happened? From y'all perspectives, what do y'all believe happened from that scenario? I told you the window I'm going to talk about. What do y'all believe happened? I'm going to read what you're saying, and I'm going to listen to you if you talk. But I want to know, I'm curious. What do y'all think happened? I want to know how much did we lie?
Okay. I'm going to tell you the story that I was told. I was told actually two different stories. The first story was that Zoka went into labor. First of all, the person that told me this, they said that Seven was flown in to be a doula for you and Zoka. Elijio had purchased a lot of stuff offline to do a home birth. The whole purpose in the doula so that you guys can go ahead and do a home birth. So a lot of us were told that Zoka went into labor. And when she went into labor, she pushed the baby out there at the house. And when the baby came out, the baby was not, you know, the baby was purple and blue or whatever, and the baby wasn't moving. Seven supposedly got the baby, you know, to cry a little bit and, you know, come back too. When they got ready to cut the umbilical cord, they said the umbilical cord was not cut properly. It wasn't tied off and cut properly, and the baby basically bled out. From that point, you guys took the baby, rushed the baby, I guess hoping it could be resuscitated, to a hospital. The one hospital told you that there was nothing they can do, so then they sent you to another hospital. And from that point, the doctor looked at the baby, they said, and they said that the baby was left at the hospital And that's one story. The other story was basically the same with the home birth at home, and that you guys buried the baby up on the trail that you guys used to walk in Puerto Rico, and that the baby was buried there. But we looked it up. I looked it up and I said, well, if that was the case, they would have had to have some type of permit in order to bury that baby there. Oh, and the third story was that a lot of people believed when you guys were creating the music video that you burned the baby in the fire, which a lot of us who have common sense know that the baby was definitely not a sacrifice that way by being burned.
So that's interesting. I'm just going to tell you this before I tell it again, and then I'm going to see what else more people have to say. But all of those are all completely false. I mean, none of that happened. I'll tell you this much. It was a normal birth. We planned to go to the hospital. You know, I was obviously the only one doing all the work, you know, to make sure that she had a hospital, she had a doctor, she had everything set up. You know, this is my first baby, so I'm doing my best, you know, speaking Spanish when I don't speak Spanish over the phone in Puerto Rico to these doctors who only speak Spanish. You know, I'm doing my best. I'm calling for hours. And, you know, I'm doing this day after day. I'm doing this for a while, and I figured it out. I eventually figured enough out to where I got something secure. You know, if anything happens and we got to roll out, I'm like, I can take control. Like, go here, call this guy, we're good. So I ended up getting myself to that point, right? We went to the hospital. We did go to the hospital, everything. Everything was normal. So when I tell you guys what happened, it'll be interesting. Is there any other stories? But none of that's true. No, nobody burned the baby. None of that happened. When we did find out the baby died, you know, it was in the hospital. I did, you know, spend some time with it for a while to see if, you know, maybe, you know, that you could re-spark the life or something, but you could tell that this was something that happened over time. So I'm going to go ahead and, you know, listen to see what else somebody else might have to say. Shaka, what you think happened?
Bro, you know, Mama Fifi called me one day and was like, you know, I know y'all used to talk, and she told me, nigga, that y'all burned the baby and ate the baby and threw it in the fire, all types of shit, bro. I was like, what the fuck?
Fifi is Scorpio.
I don't know what happened, bro, you know. I just know the way that they treated that baby, man, was unfair. The way that they talked about the baby was unfair, my nigga.
That was all unfair.
They gave a chance from the jump.
And that belief and that energy, you know, that matters. That's all the baby can pick up.
Like, when you speak that all day still into a new fetus, like, that's the crucialest time. Is the first trimester is the crucialest time. That was when it was the most crucial time, when it was calling it a demon. When he was saying that they shouldn't even had the baby. They should have never even been. They should have never did it. He was on it. Like, all he talked about.
And it's crazy because Zoka is so influential that she now, the baby's hearing that, and that baby in that field, and not to mention Zoka confused. She confused the hell.
But she riding with it though. She made a choice.
She wants to. Me and her had talk after talk. If we're gonna get an abortion, we'll get an abortion. If we're gonna keep the baby, we'll keep the baby. Let's protect it. Let's stop doing this shit. This was that night with the full moon when he first made her drink. I'm like, we never do that ever again. That's never happened and never again.
That was in California.
If we're going to get an abortion, we're going to do it. You know, and I said, and I was with it. I'm like, that's fine. That's really fine with me. But if we're not, let's go ahead and treat this shit like we're parents, you know. And so we agreed. She was crying in my arms. You got to drink that alcohol, you know. And then we agreed that, hey, I love you. You love me. We made this baby from love. We believe in this baby. We don't believe Elijio. We're going to proceed to keep this child. We made that decision in that bathroom right after he made her drink that. Because I was like, come here. No, immediately. And, you know, we hugged, we kissed, and we just stayed together and bonded for the rest of the night, me and her. You know, that's how that went. The alcohol, from that point, I was unaware of it. It was behind my back. It was on some sneaky stuff. And apparently happened more than I even heard of. Because when I left,
what happened in Vegas?
The other woman who was there, of more situations I didn't even know about. Yeah, when he made her drink alcohol on different occasions. So it's like,
that was when she had the six shots in Vegas. She had six shots in Vegas.
Upstairs. Yeah, that's crazy. She came to me after that crying.
Remember that? That was the same night of the showers, bro. That was all the same night, bro. All the same night of all the fights. All the same night of all that. That was a long fucking night, bro.
Bro, so, and how much of this? Let me ask you. How much of this that we're talking about has to do with Natiri? How much of this has to do with those posts? And how much of this that we're talking about has to do with a false imprisonment charge? None of it. This is just archives of ignored shit that people only say when they leave, because when you're there, you're under the spell. You believe in this nigga. You're not there unless you believe in this nigga. These people aren't stupid. They're like, okay, you're saying real shit. I think that you might be onto something. I'm going to come check you out. People check too deep, too early, just like us. And we, you know what I'm saying? Things change. You know what I'm saying? We get locked into it. You're not supposed to get that close to it. You know what I'm saying? We got too close to it. We got into it. And I, like people say, they described it to me. They said what I was doing right. Else, let me turn this back on. Yeah, they described it to me. They said, like, what I was basically doing was, you know, I was taking everything that I did. My homies described it to me. They said, bro, you was taking all that loyalty that you have for us in the streets and how you was and how you was raised, bro, and you gave that to him. And you let him get away with things he shouldn't have because you a rider, bro. And I'm like, I know that. Yeah, of course. I believe in him. His heart. I seen the best in him. I wanted the best for him. I believe in him. I just never know he was lying to me. He was lying on me. I mean, all the women he's ever taken was out of deceit. He was lying to Zoka. He was lying to me. He was lying to Natiri. He was lying to True. He was lying to Sheba. He was lying to Caliber. He was lying to Eferu. Everything has been deceit. So you guys can't get too mad at us. And I don't get too mad at them, because they're still there because they're deceived. And if they're still there knowing what they did, knowing what was done to them and still fighting for them, well, now they're the deceivers. They're playing the wrong side. And it's bad karma. You can see how it's playing out for him. It's not pretty. So those are some pretty crazy stories about the baby. But that's not what happened, guys. That's not what happened.
I have one quick question. Also, they said that Zoka was no potato care. She drank excessive amounts of alcohol. And also, she was being starved. He was throwing her food away in front of everybody while she was pregnant. He would take her plate of food and throw it in the trash.
Okay, no, I don't know about that. That was never because she was pregnant or anything like that. And if that happened, that's something, you know. And you know what? This is the craziest part. I can't even say that didn't happen, because this could have been some shit behind my back. I don't fucking know. But that's not nothing I'm aware of. We fed her pretty good. No, he didn't take her shopping. People donated to us, her grandmother. A lot of people helped us out to where they got us a whole baby package. He didn't do anything about that other than allow us to go to Walmart. But we, me and her, we did that shopping. That was a pretty sad story. I was telling Lotus the other day. We had went shopping, and it was sad because we were grabbing like this baby dress, and Zoka kind of was like getting really sad and kind of like cried a little bit, because she wanted to get this dress that said princess on it. And she was like, I can't get this because we'll get in trouble. And I was like, damn, that's fucked up. Like, this position that we're in, playing as servants in real life, out here about to have a baby. Now we got to treat our baby like a peasant. I'm like, it's me? I'm like, nah. I'm like, get it. Fuck that shit. Just get that shit. We'll get in trouble later. Get that shit. That's our baby's a princess. Fuck that shit. She's royalty. Just, we're royalty. Like, get it. That's ours. You know, that was a sad moment. But, you know, it's the way I know how Zoka felt about everything, and who she is now is not her. That's why she's looking all dysmorphed and crazy, because she's a whole nother person right now. She's completely lost. This is a lost soul. This is all the way out of purpose. This is sin at its best, without not knowing, without consciousness. They're bots. Their bodies are being controlled. You literally, you go there, you have to give up your whole soul, because your body is going to be under control. That's literally what it is. You know, yeah, you have to numb your pain, just like a robot, right? And he complains about having bots, but you know that's what he wants. It's very fucked up. How do you feel when he was having relations with her while pregnant with your baby? That's a good question. You know, number one, that was never really called for. I would figure that there was a certain level of respect for that. We had this idea, right, that she would stay with the women, because I'm staying with the men, and as a leader of the men, you know, I can go ahead and hold it down with the men. She can go over there. She's with Ali Hill all the time. He's a teacher. She'll go over there, and she can be there with all the women, and all the women support them. I didn't know he was going to go over there and try to have a fuck fest first day. I didn't know that. And from what I'm told, I have a story from Zoka, and I have a story from Velvet. And from what I'm told is that from both stories, Zoka didn't really want to do that. She just wanted to talk to him about some stuff. He forced it and he pressed it. And this is another one of those quote unquote rape situations. You know, the way I was given to it from one person was rape. The other way I was given it to from one person was I didn't want to do it. And so I'm like, all right, that's interesting. You know, and when I heard it from Zoka, I heard it from another woman later. I heard it from Velvet later. But from Zoka, I had heard it when I was with her, you know, because I was like, damn, like, that's fucked up. And I never let her live that down. I ain't going to cap. You know, I was always on her head about that shit. I ain't even going to cap. I always use that shit in every argument, every time. Nigga, I ain't going to cap. I use that bitch like a motherfucker. Dude, he was done after that. Like, I had a physical shield to any type of bullshit from here on out. So, you know. Anyway, you know, that wasn't the best thing. I could have did better. But, you know, anyway.
Hey, anyway.
Yeah, right, right. You know, it is what it is. But it's not cool, man. And Zoka, you know, a lot of people don't know this. Me, Zoka, and Elijah, we all had a threesome before. You know, y'all don't even know that. We all been in the same. Yeah, we all had sex all together before. Y'all don't even know that. Like, I don't think he's ever even done that with anybody else. And the way we looked at it with our dumbasses was, oh, that shit was cool. That was a great honor.
That was.
Yeah. And it was weird because he couldn't even do it. Like, he couldn't stay hard. And so he ended up leaving. And so me and Zoka just took over his room and just had sex in his room and just chilled. And put it, you know what I mean? That was weird. But that was weird.
They
go, you know?
Your ass tried. That one.
Hey, man. He tried. And he didn't think I was going to let him do it. I was like, hey, if she want to do it, y'all go ahead. Of course, she didn't want to do it. She didn't want to do it. It's a Leo full moon in Puerto Rico, so you can find a date that way. But it's a Leo full moon in Puerto Rico. The guys know because they set it up in the room. They had to set up the candles, and they're looking like,
room what the hell going on? The preppers.
They're like, what the hell going on right now? Yeah, and I mean, I ain't even going to prep the I could say that one was manipulation, but I could also say that's something I wanted to do. I ain't gonna cap. I was raised with my cousins, you know, always talking about running trains on hoes and always doing stuff like that. And here I am at Carbon years later, you know, and I'm like, I could do that.
Hey, that was y'all boot camp, man. That was summer camp, my nigga.
Yeah, I don't know. That shit is funny to me. I got a Scorpio North Node in the fifth house, so it's like I share dark secrets. You know, I'll share really funny shit like that and make it in a fun way because it is. It's funny. You know what I mean? It is. It's nothing that, you know, that's
man,
there's no
fuck
crime.
Their heads up right now.
Yeah, man. It's weird. We don't. It's just to let, I only say things like that just to let y'all know what you don't know. You know, I just let you know how much you don't know. I wanted to hear your stories before I told you just what happened. Just to let people know, like, how much they may not know from what's really true. And I say that. Go ahead. What would you say?
I said save it for the TV show.
Right. Hey, man, I want a TV show, man. I be thinking about that all the time.
Okay, can we get
a TV show, too? Chaka. Somebody call Netflix for us. Tell Keith we want a Netflix deal, too. With
Chaka,
the
let's get back on track, baby. I think you want to crack the jokes. Chaka, I'm going to mute you, Chaka.
Tell Keith get the fuck out of here. He ain't
Chaka.
Yeah, go ahead.
Let's get back on track, Chaka. You being, you can have hee-hee-ha later.
I hate you, Chaka.
Okay, let's get back on track. Come on now. Okay, so you were going to tell us the story from beginning to end about what happened to the baby.
Not from beginning to end, but from point to point, yes. I'm gonna say it from point to point. And okay. I got the Netflix documentary interview he got. So, and that's not what he's making it. He's capping on that. Just that's another cappery. But anyway.
Right.
With this story, right? So we going down the hill. I'm feeling like something's up with the baby already. You know, we going down the hill. They do the music video. We using the baby, the pregnancy for the video for really cool shots, right? He's having really bad energy during this shoot, of course. You know, and anyway, she goes into labor at one point when she's in the salt water. And so we're like, okay, cool. So we take her, you know, to the hospital, which is right there. And I knew that. I knew the hospital was right there. I had everything set up already. We were able to go straight in. I said, don't worry about it, guys. I got this. You know, Elijah needed a shirt. He was cold. I gave him my shirt. Took the shirt off my back. I'm prepared. Pulled another shirt out. Yeah, I didn't know that. You know, went in there with my little backpack, and we're in there. And this is what happened. I'm just going to tell y'all what happened, man. Hold on. Like, you know it's real. Give you this awkward moment. I mean, I guess he was nervous. I mean, okay, so we go in there, right? And what's the first thing they do? We go in there, we get admitted, whatever. She's about to give birth. They take us to the place where they do the little sonograms, you know, to sense the baby's heartbeat, right? So we go in the room. They do the little heartbeat sensor. Baby got a heartbeat. Baby's alive, right? So she's going through contractions, right? And she's sitting up in this one position and whatnot. And she has a contraction. And I can tell that this one hurt more than the other ones, right? And it was like, it was a harder one for her to get through. And I was holding her hand, you know, and I just saw that was a hard one for her to get through because she was moving positions and whatnot. And then we go to another room right after this. Baby's alive. Everything's good. Everything's all good. We go to another room. And in this room, they pretty much, they were just going to do a little, this is where they're going to do the actual little picture thing or whatever. They're going to do a picture here. And when they had did the picture, they had stopped and they didn't do the picture. And they said they had a bunch of doctors come over and they were talking. And they went back and we went back to the other room and they did the heartbeat thing again. And the heartbeat was gone. Okay. And so we're like, oh, wow, everybody's kind of in shock. We're like, wow, what just happened? You know, and we're thinking, what could have just happened? They're checking, they're doing different things. They're trying to figure things out. They're kind of like waiting. They don't really know what to do. They're calling other doctors. They're already scheduling San Juan to get us from Hotel Rey. So we are Hotel Rey. They're trying to get us from Hotel Rey to San Juan, you know, because they got better doctors, I guess. You know, it was going to be a couple hours, but they're going to give us an ambulance and get us there fast. So that, I knew that was going to happen too. That was a possibility. So anyway, we're waiting. We're trying to figure out. I'm confused. I'm confused in a mug. She's confused. Weed is there, like, she's still having contractions. You know, she's going into labor. I don't know what's really going on. I didn't know what the heartbeat was on the sensor. I didn't know what that loud sound was. I didn't know what was going on. So when the dude came and talked to me, you know, like, way later, I'm waiting. I'm getting mad. I'm calling people over. I'm trying to figure out, like, yo, what's going on? Somebody tell me what's going on. They're like, there's no pulse. And then I'm like, what do you mean there's no pulse? They're like, yeah, there's no pulse. I'm like, well, check again. They brought the whole machine over. They had the whole thing. They brought it to us this time. And they checked multiple times, checked in many different areas. They kept trying over and over again. And I'm like telling them, try here, try here. No, try here, try here, try here. We're trying everywhere. And there's no pulse at all. So the baby at this point has no pulse already this early. And so it gets to the point where they give us it's some time. And we're just like figuring out what to do. I'm consoling her. She's like, the baby's dead. The people there, they're telling us, like, hey, guys, this happens all the time. Don't worry about it. You guys can be able to try again. This and that. They're basically, you know, they're defeated about it. I'm like, no, there's still something that can be done. I know something can be done. There got to be something that can be done. There's some. Where's the reverse baby engineering healing system? Go get it. Like, you know, I'm like, where is it? Like, I know you got the little baby defibrillators. Go grab them. You know, I'm like, something got to be there. And, you know, at a certain point, I had to kind of accept it. And I was like, you know what? Even if this is the case, I'm like, I'm not going to let this defeat me. And I can't be weak because she can't have that right now. I can't be over here crying, breaking down next to her because then what she's going to do, same thing. So I'm over here knowing I got to be tough for her. I got to do all that. So I'm like, you know what? This and that. Everything's fine. This and that. Everything's for a reason. Everything's fine. All this beautiful stuff, right? And I'm saying it in a way to where it's coming out good. I'm saying it in a way. Me and her did a little video. We recorded it. We were smiling. We were happy. I was making her laugh. Even in that circumstance, I'm making her laugh, you know, making her happy, you know. And so we get to the point to where it's like the best way to go about this is to give labor, because if you do surgery, it's just too much extra stuff that we have to account for. But if she just gives labor, it's the easiest way. You know, you don't really have to worry about too many complications because the baby already has no pulse. So she went into full-blown labor. We went into San Juan Hospital, and we went all the way there, and she had to give birth to the baby that was dead. And so essentially, this whole time, the baby's having no pulse. You know, I'm feeling around. I'm still hoping. I'm waiting. You know, my hand's not leaving her stomach. None of that, you know what I mean, type of thing. You know, we eventually get to San Jose, right? that I'm getting all this information. I'm not stopping at talking to doctors. I'm getting all the information possible of what could have possibly caused this. I'm asking everybody I come across, what causes this type of thing? What could cause this? What could cause this? What's the one thing that they all said? Well, it could have been poison. It could have been alcohol. Mm-hmm. It could have been maybe food or alcohol or poison. And I was like, what? They're like, yeah, those are the only things that would do something like this. It wasn't anything. They're going off of what they know. The baby hasn't been delivered yet. So we go and deliver the baby. And this is what they're telling me. I'm researching it online. That's all you see online. You guys go research it online for yourself. All you're going to see is alcohol. That's it. That's all you're going to see. It's just going to say alcohol, 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 alcohol. That's it. So right. At the end of the day, the baby, we give birth, right? And the baby comes out, and of course the baby's dead. I think the baby's beautiful. It's unfortunate that you could tell that the baby's dead because, you know, the muscles aren't being used, but she has her nice weight to it. She has all her toes. She has a full head of hair. She has every feature was just beautiful. You know, it was literally like another little me as a girl. To me, she looked like a Jhené Aiko, but kind of like with like my face. It was very interesting to me. She's beautiful, absolutely beautiful, beautiful little girl, you know, absolutely gorgeous. And I got to hold her, and she had her weight to her. She had all her toes. She was like a healthy girl, like a healthy baby, all the way healthy. You know what I mean? And it was crazy. You could tell that the problem here was when you seen the placenta, you'll see in the veins in the placenta, there's certain areas and certain veins that are just like all green and black, and you can tell it's bad because it's affecting the area around it. You know, it's affecting the flesh around it. So it's like these areas were poisoned, but the baby literally made it this far. It literally made it that far. Like if we would have went in labor earlier, we might have baby love today. But the thing is, it made it that far. And so the poison, this is what the doctor told me, the placenta was poisoned. The baby did make it pretty far, but he doesn't know how the baby made it that far. He doesn't know what kept the baby alive that long because the placenta been poisoned. And I was like, no way, no way. And I'm immediately looking at Zoe like, we got to tell the people it was the birth, it was the cord. We got to tell them it was the cord. Because if they hear this, they're going to know it was him. And I'm telling her this, and I'm like, damn, it was him. It was him. And you can ask her. I want this whole flaring fit, angry about him, knowing it was him, ready to leave, ready for everything, all that. You know what I mean? Ready to do the worst. And it got to the point to where I'm like, you know what? I can't blame him at this point. You know? I can't blame him at this point. This is the sickest part, and this is what's going to fucking make you guys sick. This is a sick part, right? I gotta turn the camera off for this one. This is a sick part. We get on the phone. We get on the phone with Elijio. We get on the phone with bro. We tell him what happens. I'm telling what happened. We're sad. You know, we're hoping to hear him. You know, at least this is a time of compassion. His first thing to do was to start cussing us out once we told him the news. He started cussing us out. And all he was saying was how people are going to worry about him and how people are going to talk about him and how people are going to get mad at him and how everything that we did, you know, we never think about him. How could we be so selfish? You know, this, and that. You know, and I didn't necessarily, like, I figured out his energy, and I didn't necessarily match his energy as much as I wanted to. What I did was I let him know, I'm like, I basically just, like, had let him know he was wrong. He asked me if I think he did that. I let him know, yeah, I know he did that. I know this was him. I said, yeah, it was you. I know it was you. And he's like, man, I can't believe you let those demons get to you. I can't believe you let those shadows get to you. I was born in crack smoke. I was born in this. That alcohol don't kill a baby. If that was happening, it was divine. And he was just saying that. And I'm over here like, he really like, bro, y'all got to understand how much we cared about this dude. This is how much we cared about him. This is how much they care about him, to the point where they'll stay there after he's beat them, kicked them in the stomach, stomped on their head, pummeled them into tubs. And I wish I was talking shit, but I'm just telling truth. The conversation with him went so crazy that I basically, I think I said something, I cussed at him. I knew I said something very angry. I cussed at him and hung up on him while he was just talking and ranting and raving, just hung up on him. And he kept calling back, and I was like, sorry, we don't have service. And I told Zoka, I'm saying, we don't have service right now. We ain't got service. Put the phone up. And then I just sat there with her. And then me and her just, you know, we held the baby for a while. She held the baby. I held the baby for a while. They let us spend time. They cleaned the baby up and everything and let us hold the baby and everything, dead and all. And, yeah, I was hoping for it was one of those revival moments. It wasn't one of those moments. The baby had been dead. And if she wasn't dead already, if she came out, she probably would have died shortly afterwards because she was, you know, living off of poison placenta for so long. Who knows when that took place? So we're telling the world what? Umbilical cord. What's the easy way to tell them? Oh, the baby got choked by the umbilical cord on labor. And if you guys remember that live we did in Puerto Rico, where she was telling the story, she had said the umbilical cord because I had told her to say that. You know, I had told her to say that. Me and her, we came up with a whole game plan to protect him. He was very proud with it. He let it all go. He was cool with it. He was cool with the umbilical cord thing, right? He let us do it. He let us say it. And then we had all the fake tears and all the fake care and the fake love for Zoka after that, and all hugged her. And I made sure I called in that night to let people know how powerful she was and what she went through. And that's the night I called in. And actually, I saved that. I saved that recording, and it's in the computer that the police have. But I remember that. And I did that on purpose because I was like, you ain't shit for even going live and talking about this, trying to get beans off of it. I'm already feeling like that. You ain't shit because you know you're wrong. I'm always feeling like that. He knows that. Forever, I always knew it was him. You know, I let him get away with a lot. I know I'm crazy. Say what you got to say about me now. It is what it is. That's who I was then. You know, and I have it in my song, one of my more recent songs, the song that you like so much. I can give him a sample of it. I got a song that I made. I just recorded it. I just made the beat, wrote the song, recorded it all within like an hour or two, just sitting there one day. And in the song, one of the lyrics, you know, I say, you know, the first time was you, this one's on me. Won't make those same mistakes again. Take care of your seeds. Because I realized, like, bro, from the beginning, from the jump, I should have been left with Zoka. And you know what's crazy? I had many opportunities to do that. And that right there would have been the man turning point that y'all were looking for. Everything after that was whack. Everything after that point is already whack. I'm already somewhere we already somewhere we're not supposed to be. This is not a place for babies, pregnant women, children, women, any of that people. It's not a place for people to go to his life. No. There's a reason why you warn people from going to his life, because hey, it's not what it looks like. Let me tell you what's really going on. That's why people do that. That's why I'm doing it. Because I do what? I have a program. I have a network called what? Soul Redemption. Sovereignty in every dimension. We getting money out here. We built a bad relationship with money. We built a bad relationship with success. We built a bad relationship with everything, with ourselves. We have to undo that. I teach real self-love. I teach the knowledge for real. I always was the best teacher at Carver Nation for a reason, because I'm really about the knowledge. I always have been. I would love to challenge Elihu on the knowledge publicly, because I did it on the phone with him the other day, and I defeated everything he said. Everything he said. Destroyed him. He said he wanted to be my student. I wasn't even going to tell you that, but fuck it. Because I'm in the mode. It's on the little rift, you know? So I was like, yeah. Bro, I was just on the phone with him the other day. He said he wanted to be my student. I'm like, all right. I'd love to teach you, but I just don't have the time. I have a group for that. I got a group for that. You got to catch my class at 2. Can you catch my class at 2? I'm not making a special class for you unless you're making a special class for you unless you pay me. You willing to pay me? $100 entry. Can you do $100 entry? I'll teach you. But I'm not moving how you moved. You see what I'm saying? I don't even know if you need this knowledge, because who knows what you're going to do with it. The whole point of me doing charts in the beginning is to make sure that we align with the person's purpose. I know, and I know how to really deal with them, and we can really get to the point quick so that we don't have to deal with any shenanigans. We're actually mature. It's a sovereign nation. Everybody got to handle themselves and deal with themselves. It's nothing to just get removed from something. That's not hard. It's like, okay, you're being disrespectful. Goodbye. You don't have to be a part of this network. Go be individual over there. You don't have to. We don't even have our.
Just make it go.